All right. Well, good morning and welcome to the Simons Institute. My name is Peter Bartlett. I'm the Associate Director here. Very happy to see you all here. We're a collaborative research institute focused on theoretical computer science and its connections to other areas of science and technology and society. And of course, statistics and data science have become hugely important in all areas of our lives and also in computer science. And we're seeing this increased emphasis on topics that touch on statistics, touch on data science in the collaborative research programs that we run here at the Institute. And, you know, of course, very, very happy to be hosting this workshop this week on statistics and remind me, what was the title? Statistics and its role in the big data era, right? That was not it. and very happy to be celebrating the occasion of 2 years after Peter Bickel's 80th birthday. We've been making, you know, many attempts to make this workshop happen. So thrilled that it could finally happen in person. A big thank you to the organizers, Haiyan Huang, Lisa Lavina, Peter Buhlmann, Peng Ding, Junkin Fan, Katarina Kirkris, and Yanki Ritov. And also a big thank you to, she's just stepped out, Ashley Hassan has done a great job with all the local arrangements. So big thanks to all of those folks. And just a couple of quick words on logistics before I hand over to Lisa. So at lunchtime, you can leave your stuff in lockers on the far side of the building. They operate with a PIN code. So, you know, that should be more convenient for many of you. And for speakers, our videographer here, Omid Farr, is going to be helping with computers and microphones. All right. Oh, and today, thank you. I'll forget everything if it's not written down, you see that. Today is the first Wednesday of the month. And so at 12 o'clock, there'll be a siren that'll slowly build up and a voice that will say, this is a test. It is just a test, so relax. And whoever's the speaker who's supposed to finish at 12, you know you get a special warning there.
Thank you, Peter. Well, welcome everyone to this workshop. It's hard to believe it's finally happening. I was trying to remember when we started planning it. I couldn't actually find the oldest email, but I know I created the folder for this conference in July 2018. So it's been 4 years, and initially looked like a very easy conference to organize because anybody you ask, you say, I'm organizing a conference for Peter Bickel's birthday. Would you like to come? And they say, yes, immediately. So that's been great. And then it was planned for May 2020 originally. So it's finally happening. I'd just like to thank a few people. First of all, I need to thank Peter himself for letting me do this. He was slightly reluctant, but he agreed. And also Nancy, who has been very supportive. I'd like to thank my co-organizers, Peter and the staff at the Simons Institute, Ashley and Quilani, who have been very helpful. Also Judy McDonald, my assistant, who's done a lot of work. And I think you all have gotten emails from her and the Berkeley staff, and all the speakers and all of you who are finally here today in person. And I'll hand over to the current chair of the Berkeley Statistics Department, Sandrine Dudoit.
Thank you very much, Lisa, and thank you to all the organizers for putting together this conference. And good morning, everyone. So my first encounter with Peter Bickel was 30 something years ago as an undergraduate student through a book that's often simply refers to as Bickel and Doxa. My second encounter was through a letter, my letter of admission to the PhD program at Berkeley, which was signed by Peter, who was then the department chair. And then my third encounter was through a door in Evans Hall that had Peter's name on it. What the Star Trek PhD student eventually discovered was that behind these seminal books and these doors bearing illustrious names, Bickle, Blackwell, Raymond, Friedman, Lehman, to name only a few, were wonderful teachers, scholars, colleagues, and friends. Peter is part of a distinguished lineage of statisticians who have shaped and continue to shape our discipline. His academic grandfather is none other than Jerzy Neyman, the founder of our department, and also one of the founding fathers of modern statistics. His academic father is Eric Lehman. Peter received his PhD from Berkeley in 1963 with a dissertation on asymptotically nonparametric statistical inference in the multivariate case. According to the Math Genealogy Project, he has 61 children, 744 descendants, and that doesn't even include the myriad young researchers he has mentored. His numerous children continue to push the boundaries of statistics and data science at academic institutions and companies around the world. And many of them are here today at the workshop, including the workshop organizers. So Peter's contribution has spanned the breadth of our discipline in areas that include asymptotic theory, semi-parametric models, the bootstrap hidden Markov models. He has recently been working on statistical methods for genomic data analysis and has been a wonderful mentor to one of my postdocs. I never cease to be amazed by Peter's energy, curiosity, and passion for learning and understanding. His commitment to the department and to the university is exceptional. It's been a pleasure and privilege to know him first as a student and then as a colleague. So I'm delighted that we have the occasion to celebrate Peter this week. The diversity of talks on the conference program is a testimony to Peter's broad scientific reach. And the audience gathered here today also reflects the friendships he has developed with so many. And now, among the persons who have known Peter for several decades, I'm delighted to introduce Jennifer Chayes, who is the Associate Provost for the new Division of Computing, Data Science and Society, Dean of the School of Information and Professor of Statistics, Electrical Engineering and Computer Sciences and Mathematics.
Thanks so much, Sandrine, and good morning to everyone. It is really wonderful to see you all here, and I assume there are many more of you online to celebrate Peter with us. The topic of the workshop, Statistics in the Big Data Era, is to a large extent due to Peter himself. In all of the, you know, with all of his students and his descendants, as we just heard. The topic is near and dear to my heart as we form the Division of Computing, Data Science, and Society at Berkeley. We are on our way to becoming the first new college at Berkeley in over half a century. And this is, of course, due in large part to the legacy of Peter, others I'm seeing here, I'm seeing Ben, I'm seeing so many people. You know, Peter has really helped to shape the direction that statistics has taken at Berkeley and is fundamental to what we are building here. The workshop provides a natural opportunity to celebrate Peter's 80th birthday, as we heard, a couple of years late. He's long been one of the world's leading statisticians, and to name a few areas in which he has pioneered research, adaptive estimation, asymptotic theory, computational biology, decision theory, machine learning, resampling methods, and semi and non-parametric modeling. And I'm sure I've missed many other topics. Congratulations, Peter, for making such significant contributions to your own field of statistics and far beyond. I believe I first met Peter 15 or 20 years ago. We were both members of what is now known as the Board of Mathematical Sciences and Analytics, BMSA, of the National Academies. I recall that Peter first joined ex officio because he was chair of CATS, which was the Committee on Statistics for the National Academies. He then became chair of the BMS, which was, as we were just talking about, an unusual choice. I think the National Academies realized that they needed a strong leader to help move the Board of Mathematical Sciences more towards applications. During my tenure there with Peter as our fearless leader, and he reminded me also, Margaret Wright and Peter and I were really strong advocates to change the name of the Board of Mathematical Sciences to put an A at the end. The A was originally for applications. It's now been changed to analytics. So yes, I hadn't even known that either, Peter, and I saw him shaking his head. No, you know, things change, but they kept the acronym. I'm sure you can imagine it was not an easy change for this preeminent National Mathematics Board, but Peter really helped everyone to understand that mathematics needed to embrace the full range of applications. Here we are today discussing this range of applications and analytics afforded by math and statistics, especially in this new era of rapidly increasingly large data sets. And I'm delighted that we're doing this in Peter's honor. I know that all of you, as Peter, are deeply invested in strengthening core statistical theory and methods, along with applications of statistics to problems in a range of domain-specific areas, from genomics to social networks. Working on core issues in mathematics and statistics, even in the absence of real-world applications, is absolutely thrilling. Indeed, Peter has spent much of his career doing this, as have I. I think we are both enamored of the beauty of mathematics and statistics. But developing and applying new statistical methods to pressing societal changes, from misinformation and bias to biomedicine and human health, to climate change and sustainability, to human welfare and social justice, has become increasingly important as the world looks to statisticians to find approaches and solutions to the urgent problems of our time. We need a human-centered approach to statistics so that we can better frame the perspective and purpose and anticipate the problems. But we also need tremendous innovation in the core of statistics to move our work dramatically forward, addressing the most difficult technical challenges and realizing the greatest opportunities. Together with Peter as our example, we can lead the way in developing solutions to these challenges and in educating the next generation to carry this mission into the future. Thank you, and happy belated birthday.
unfortunately have to take off.